So obviously we are in the thick of training camp, and Boss Cowboy is going to present measure Kool-Aid on something that I see forming. Because training camp is something that you have to be very aware. And it's not just about the battles and the competitions. You also have to, in my opinion, look at the rotations and try to get the clues of what the potential future could be. Especially when you merge it with talking points and what we hearing from press conferences. So I'm gonna measure this Kool-Aid and I'm gonna try to put it all together. So y'all just kind of stay with me on this one. And it starts with a thought that came from Amari Cooper. This is not about Amari Cooper. This is more so about the thought. So check this out and listen closely.
Think I can help change that for sure.
Amari, you're such a pro, though. Is that a conversation that you just kind of walk up at practice and kind of talk to Kellen Moore a little bit? You say, hey, you know, or you just see the game plan, you know, okay, this week I got a shot because 2 weeks ago we played these guys. I know who's going to cover me this week again. Is it something you say to the OC, or is it just something you kind of say, hey, I'm just going to just go out here and practice and do what I'm supposed to do?
Yeah, I mean, we communicate with each other, you know, me, Kellen, Dak, you know, we talk about what we like and what we don't like. It's just a matter of it being put into the actual game plan or being caught in the actual game. Typically, we never run any play in the game that we don't practice that week. So you would.
Let me rewind that, because that's the key part right there.
Yeah, I mean, we communicate with each other, you know, me, Kellen, Dak, you know, we talk about what we like and what we don't like. It's just a matter of it being put into the actual game plan or being caught in the actual game. Typically, we never run any play in the game that we don't practice that week. So you would know throughout the course of the week how much you're going to get targeted for real.
So that's the key thought, because that gives you insight on how the Dallas Cowboys operate, which is how most teams likely operates. There are not many teams that build exotic contingency plans that just leaves it all on the quarterback. They have to plan for specific ways to attack a particular matchup, but that also gives you a clue of how important and how practices are used. So he said, we never go into a game without practicing what's going to happen that week. Well, that's the same thing you could also likely then deduct from training camp. Is you look at training camp to try to say, okay, what are they doing in training camp? Because this is based on a big picture of how they're preparing. So what does that have to do with the thumbnail and the idea of what I'm talking about, with likely they're preparing for Tyler Smith to take over for Tyron Smith, even in 2022? I don't think it's as long term as what people think. I think it's something that they really looking at now. So obviously we had a super show, and this was one of the topics that came up, and you know, it led to a debate, and that's okay. And it was a lot of options. I did another breakdown on particular options. So option three was my something that I think the Cowboys are strongly leaning on when you look at their OTAs, their mini camps, and then now let's look at what's going on. And option three was the contingency plan if Tyron Smith went down. Okay. And so in option three, I talked about that they likely going to move Tyler Smith to left tackle, which he also played in college, and they're gonna likely move up Connor McGovern to left guard, especially because he had some reps at left guard and he can build on those reps. Well, am I crazy? Well, I don't think I'm crazy at all. And I think that's exactly what they're doing, because they're continuing that thought process and they're continuing that pattern. So if you go look at Twitter, right, and you look at what came out from Michael Gielkin, right? Michael Gielkin did a breakdown, and let's just kind of look at it. So he talked about a lot of things, but if we look at the clues of what's happening, right? He said Connor McGovern And rookie, oh, let me make this bigger. Make this bigger for everybody because it's good to see. When you can see, you can't say I'm lying. All right, Connor McGovern and rookie first round pick Tyler Smith in that order. Shared first team reps at left guard Wednesday. Smith is considered the favorite to start September 11 at Tampa Bay Buccaneers. His work was concentrated at guard during a short practice. Okay, so stay with this. This is important. But he is expected to resume cross training. Oh my God! And isn't that what I said on the Super Show? Isn't that exactly the term that I use? Cross training. Now, I got a lot of pushback on that, and I'm cool with that. And guess what? I took a public L because it wasn't about me, right? But then I think I took that L too fast because at the same time, boss, what you said is lining up. They using the even the exact terms that you use where I said I think they should cross train Tyler Smith to be the left tackle. But that's also what they doing. He said, but he's expected. This is coming from Michael Gilkin, who was a guest on the show 2 weeks ago. He said, expected to resume cross training between the left tackle and guard before long. So what does that mean? So when you combine that thought with what Amari said, where we never do in a game and go into a game without first practicing it. That's what we looking at. We looking at them preparing, and I'm just being honest, y'all. I think they preparing for the contingency of losing potentially Tyron Smith. I'm just being honest, y'all. I'm not trying to take shots at him because I love him. He's going to be a Hall of Famer. But I'm paying attention. I'm listening. Especially when you got Stephen Jones coming out in his press conference. We got to give these young guys a chance. And we know he's trying to do that over money.
At the same time, I do think opportunity is so key. And we've seen so much in some of these younger players. Whether it's a CD, whether it's a Gallup, whether it's a Tolbert, as you mentioned, we obviously thought a lot of them or we wouldn't have drafted him that high. You look over on the defensive side of the ball and you look at a Dorrance Armstrong and you see the production he was able to put out there and, you know, probably half the number of plays that some of the guys had. You want a Sam Williams, who we obviously think a lot of. We had a big grade on him. I think, you know, he's going to need his opportunity to step up. You know, you give these young tackles who we've put some resources into, first round picks, third round picks. You know, some of these guys, they just need a chance to get out there. And boy, they've been behind a very well respected group in the NFL for 10 years. We've been mentioned year in and year out as one of the best offensive lines in football. So, it's time for some of these guys, and it's not like we're just hoping someone shows up out here. I mean, we've had our hands on these players, for this whole offseason, and then in some cases like a ball and a steal, we've had our hands on them for several years now. So we're obviously very comfortable, or we would have gone out and gotten us a swing like we've done almost every year, a swing tackle. But we've just got too much upside in these guys here and feel it's their time to step up.
We know that. You know, this is about money. This is about cap. And nobody is thinking more cap conscious than Stephen Jones. But we got to give these young guys a chance. But then let's take a quick look at what he's doing. When you take a quick look at what he's doing and you take a quick look at how they're, like Amari said, rotating in their practices, I see what you're doing, Dallas. I really do. I really do think the clue is simple, especially when you add in Stephen Jones. We need these young guys. These young guys need a chance. And then every time he talked about the young guys, who did he bring up? Steele, Matt, Josh Ball. He keep talking about tackle. To me, that's a clue. I mean, I'm just being honest. That's a clue of what they intend to do. It's also not bad because it's putting pressure on guys who typically don't play through the seasons to get through these seasons and to be more like Zeke. That's why they have Zeke back, because you can, like it or not, Zeke played tough, and he was borderline crazy to play through what he played through in 2021. But that craziness, in a good way, was deemed to be sacrifice for your team and earning your contract. So I'm just kind of giving the measure Kool-Aid of what I see going on. And I'm gonna tell y'all right now, at this point, yeah, it was a debate about it, but it shouldn't be a debate at this point, because it's starting to become clear. And especially if they keep doing what they're doing in training camp, where we seeing a lot of reps at Connor McGovern at practice, right? Knowing likely they go start Tyler Smith at left guard, but they giving him a lot of starter reps, because I guarantee you they're preparing also for the contingency plan. Yeah, they preparing for the contingency plan. So even though it was a lot of options, and I got up to 7 different options that the Dallas Cowboys could do if they lost Tyron Smith temporarily, but option 3 to me is actually what the Cowboys are absolutely leaning on. And just like Amari said, that's what they're practicing and preparing for. So this is Boss Cowboy Sports, man, where your voice matter. I'm gonna continue to get this type of content and make our voices matter. Make sure, please, that you continue to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to hit that like on the way out. But this is the Measure Kool-Aid Report, and this is exactly what I believe is going down. So keep your eyes on training camp, on more than just the battles, but also the clues. Y'all stay up. It's Boss Cowboy Sports. Peace.